The CubeSat project was a collaboration between us and the JPL, and it involved basically building a CubeSat, which is a small satellite, and it would carry an experiment, and the rest of it was built by the students here. As far as what JPL and NASA expect to learn is, it's basically how a new form of storing energy will work in space.
So in April, the CubeSat was loaded onto a rocket which was launched up to the International Space Station. Then it was unloaded into the space station where it sat for about a month. At that time, when the astronauts had time in their schedule, they took the CubeSats in their deployers, and then on May 17th in the evening, the deployer door was open and our CubeSats were launched into space. The CubeSat it's orbiting in what they call a low Earth orbit. The orbit's approximately 90 minutes and continually orbiting the Earth. So the ground station has a few components. All of them were designed, built, programmed by our students and faculty. One component is the tracking station. That's how we track the satellite and we point our antenna so that we can communicate with it. Then we have what we call mission control, which is where we communicate with the satellite. We send it up commands telling it what we want to do. And then third, we have the telemetry station where we can take the data it's sent down and we can look at it in graphical form to get an understanding of how things are working up there. And so we're out there looking, we're talking to JPL in the hopes that we can have another project to build.